We're wondering if Minnesota was real. This is about as real as it gets. It's a 1968 Mustang with a 67 drivetrain, so I call it a 67 and a half. And if you're a Mustang person, then you get the joke. If not, you can look it up. This is a 67 and a half Mustang. And you might even notice that I have a 67 hubcap on the front wheel and a 68 on the rear wheel.
Yeah. Hey guys, it's the Chappers. I'm in America. As you can see behind me, it's incredibly American. And in particular, this is Minnesota, where I have been really enjoying myself. Today is my birthday. I am now 39 years of age. I've enjoyed almost all of them. And I have the privilege to introduce to you the wondrous and very nice, charming man, this Joe, from
Happy birthday, Rob.
Riff City Guitar.
Happy birthday twice.
Riff City Guitar!
This is the Mississippi. It's my first ever time, second ever time.
M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. Let's hear it.
M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. Yeah.
Jesus.
Now tell me about the cheese.
I feel bad, but I don't feel bad.
Is it oozing? This guy's a wizard. Thank you very much for buying this beautiful guitar that Rick is now setting up for you. And what kind of stuff do you play?
I'm just a beginner. I'm just learning my chords and
me too.
A few things.
Don't laugh. No laughing.
Please laugh.
No laughing.
Laughing is great.
What do you do in this situation?
Tell her not to laugh. Okay, and action.
Smile though.
This is number 2 of 50.
This is Franklin.
I got Rob Chapman's number.
Quick, great. Don't show them the number on YouTube. That's a hell of a top. Look at that. That's really nice.
Oh, yeah.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
Rich just setting up one of the ML7s. And I just specifically noticed how lovely that top is. That's like a piece of modern art. More pedalia, a daughter. She's handling your money, dude.
That's okay.
She's very good at it. You're okay with that, yeah?
I'm very okay with it.
Okay.
Anybody can handle the money.
I think she's giving it to somebody else.
We're trying to teach customers to check themselves out, actually.
She's giving this guy money.
Yes.
Okay.
I'll take the money.
All right. He's taking the money, Joe.
It's okay.
Okay, as long as you're fine with that.
Picture or a video?
It's Franklin.
This is Rob Chapman.
I like him immensely.
The greatest guitar player I've ever met.
In this room.
In real life.
Stood on
ever.
This tile. Give me one of these. That's awesome. So is there a serial number on this one?
Mm-hmm. It is right there.
Okay, so it's 140044. Whoever gets that is extremely lucky. I mean, they're all great, but that's particularly enchanting.
And this is sort of like a museum of my life. I bought the car in 1979. So you'll see back there in my cassette case some of the bumper stickers to the radio stations I've worked for throughout the years.
Wow.
Including Rockin' 101, the station that you were on.
You put some time into that seat, buddy.
Oh, yeah. I did. And I got this car the week before my very first rock and roll concert, which was Kiss, and so I always have my Kiss Alive tape there.
Oh, yeah.
And I have a working 8-track tape. Did they have those in England?
They did. They may not anymore.
Well, there's no reason anymore, but I still have a working 8-track tape player.
And original brand Tic Tacs.
That's right.
Birthday yesterday?
Yes.
In UK.
Oh, that's right.
And then you had one today.
Oh, it's my double birthday.
That's special.
First time I've ever had a double birthday.
Cheers.
Would you do me the immense... Joe with the Joe.
Yes.
Would you do me the immense privilege and honour of helping to show my YouTube friends around your store?
Why would I not?
I don't know.
Is there any question?
No.
Love to show you our store.
As you can see, we have ukuleles.
Yeah. So we'll start to the side. We have mixing desks and microphones and stuff. Oh, look, Hughes and Kettner.
Oh, yeah.
That's interesting because in the UK, well, specifically Andertons, I don't think we actually sell Hughes and Kettner a lot. But you find that kind of a
great brand.
Yeah.
It's a very economical two-head. Sounds great.
Lights up and looks pretty, doesn't it?
And people in the Midwest love them.
Really?
Yeah, they really do.
Wow. I know it's
good brand.
Obviously big in Germany. But I've not seen a lot of Hughes and H&K stuff. I've actually never ever played a Hughes and Kettner. I don't think. Maybe I have once in a World Guitars video years ago. But
we can fix that. We should try one.
Okay, I'll do that. So what's this room?
This is our acoustic room. So all of the acoustic guitars, our ukuleles, resonators, banjos.
Resonators. It's all about resonators.
Yes. They call them Dobros.
So you got different brands.
Lots of different brands of acoustic guitars. Acoustic guitars sell at a very, very high rate, probably a lot more than electric guitars.
I don't know
if that's common in the UK. But
I would say that's uncommon in the UK.
No.
But the thing is, your popular music over here is very much instruments and guitars. And I suppose the predisposition of beginners is to start with an acoustic, generally.
Very much so.
Yeah.
And I think the style of music that's most prevalent in the Midwest, and certainly in our area, lots and lots of coffee shop players.
You got Martins, obviously.
We have Martin, yep. We have Yamaha, Fender, Seagull,
Gretsch,
Lag, which is one of our very, very popular, interesting line that not a lot of people know about.
Lag. I've played a lot of Lag. They're really good guitars.
They're really good guitars, and they're very interesting. They look nice. They sound good.
Hey, random customer that I don't know.
No.
How you doing? I don't know you. This is my friend Will, and Will is a special guy. Will was one of the first guys in America to play a hot rod.
You want it like that, and then you want the like that. Play that. That's good.
Hey,
I see you have some TC Electronic.
We love TC Electronic.
Yeah, so do I, man. They're very cool.
Ah, this is something you might want to try while you're here. You may not have that.
I buy the amp brand.
Andertons.
Oh, that's cool.
It's a really cool pedal.
Siamese Drive.
Yes, so you got two different kinds of
boost. I love the fact that it's the eyes.
Yes, and they light up.
That's great.
They look angry.
That's probably the best boost pedal in the world, as far as I'm concerned.
And it's a
that one's great, but this one, man, I have it on my board. I also have this, I have this. I have a load of them. Yeah. Javelina. Oh, way huge.
We do great with Keeley.
I love Keeley.
Yes.
Yeah.
Robert is a, he's a genius.
What's that? Oh, the Luna. Java. Yeah, Keeley's an absolute genius. And then you got the Electro-Harmonics and the Morley.
The staple.
Crate. Went to a gig at a honky-tonk bar and saw a band called...
Shenandoah.
At a honky-tonk bar. What was the honky-tonk bar called?
Raleigh's. Raleigh's Rednecks and Longies.
You know what? I'll include a clip right now. And the guitar player was playing a Boss. What was it? It was a
GT3 with an Ampeg amp.
Yes. And I was like, really?
And it sounded great.
Not that I'm tonist, but I mean, it sounded phenomenal. And I was floored. Absolutely floored.
I had a caller. She called me the night she turned 18. And she requested Alice Cooper's I'm 18. On her 18th birthday. And of course I played it for her and I got to know her as Alice, but her real name is Terry. I later began to call her Miss Domino Plastercaster, and she became a stripper for a while. And here's the reason why. Here she is. I took her to her first concert, Kiss, the reunion tour in 1996. I got free tickets to the radio station, and they were excellent tickets, third row. And she dressed up. She says, I'm getting backstage. And I said, well, Terry, there's going to be 20,000 people there. It's going to be hard to get backstage. And she said, you just watch me. So here she is.
Yeah.
With her attitude. And I'm hoping that I can get together and have a beer with her later today.
Yes.
After all these years.
Fantastic,
And she did get backstage. She zipped her dress down and flashed Ace Frehley.
Wow.
And got backstage and met Kiss.
That's incredible.
I'm Al Neff. I'm the host of the Into the Music radio series. It's on public and commercial radio. We have 225 hours on the greatest artists and events in music history. It's time to get into the music. I'm Al Neff.
And what's quite cool for me is that a lot of these guitars are not guitars that I'm familiar with. As in, you've got some of the DBZ stuff.
Yes.
Interesting to me. And you have classic Boss pedals. What are these? A Fender.
Yes. You haven't seen those?
No.
They're actually very cool.
Never even seen them before.
Yeah, they're awesome.
When did these come out?
About a year ago.
That's really strange.
You'll need to try one later.
I don't know why I've never even seen these. Quite surprised that Lee hadn't shown me or somebody had shown me. Mm-hmm. A lot of gear here. So yeah, we got some Gretches, we got some Fenders.
Jackson, we do very well with Jackson.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me, the States. So here we got some DBZ. Now, I'm not very familiar.
The Mavericks are kind of new.
We just got an okay sold on camera. That was a great moment. This is pretty cool. And I'm interested in sort of what's different about them. But like, it's pretty obvious that's going to sell loads, isn't it?
Yes.
Now, do you know anything about these you can tell me?
This is a very interesting guitar. And as soon as these came out, I decided we needed to have these in every color, of course.
Mm.
This one comes in the very high technical color of red.
Yeah!
Yes, yes. It has inlays that are technically a rhombus. No, I take that back. They are actually square.
All six.
It's a six string.
Okay.
It was not a seven string
okay.
at any given time in its life. I can assure you of that.
This one came with a neck.
They're very popular. It did come with a neck. A set through neck.
Yeah, bro.
Switch.
Yes.
So you can change the sound
okay,
when you
that's
want.
Good.
You
that's
can
good.
Go here. Listen, can you hear it? Most important thing is at Riff City Guitar, it's $849.99. That's dollars, not pounds.
Dollars, not pounds. $849.99, $93.92.
Right.
Quid.
It could be anything.
You know what I really like? That headstock. That's a great looking headstock. DBZ Diamond. And they do a lot of cool carving. It's a nice thing. It's a nice touch.
Straps.
Soldier straps are taking the... It's the world, I want to say universe, because it's that cool, but they are taking the world by storm. These are awesome straps, mostly made of seatbelt material.
Oh, I see, recycled.
A neat rubber end.
Oh, so it doesn't come off.
Right.
That's a very clever idea. So they're recycled seatbelts.
Yes, with prints.
With prints and rubber ends. That's a very, very clever idea.
They're very affordable and extremely popular.
That's awesome.
They're not all, they don't all have the rubber strap. There's a lot of other soldiers brand straps.
That that's great. Coffee.
Yes, there's coffee.
Which you give to your customers.
I just thought of something. I did a video where we talked about cookies. And I remember that I forgot about the most important cookie on the planet is the oatmeal raisin. I feel very bad. We talked about the Snick Core Doodle, and we talked about the Classic Chalk, and we talked about the Claw Hammer, but I completely and rudely left out the Country Raisin. Every Riff City customer gets a cookie if they want it, of course, and coffee. There's always coffee on when you come in the store. It's like you're at home.
And you're fine with customers to come in and play guitars and just hang out and not buy anything?
It's funny. The other stores in our town often have a sign that says, please ask for assistance.
Yeah.
Our sign says, please play the guitars.
Does it really?
Yes.
Where's that sign?
I don't have it.
Hey, Nat.
Hello.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Higgins and Burke T.
Are you playing guitar now?
This machine is amazing.
Is it really?
Just take that out.
This is Nat's favorite thing in the building.
Oh, I have to add water.
Good. Well, I hope.
do another one. Thank you. Oh, thank you very much. Hang on.
You're a bassist.
I'm a bass player.
Yes. So
that's why if you get more than four strings, it's very, very complex for me. Very complicated.
And what kind of bass do you own?
I am a huge Music Man fan, so I have five Music Man basses. Do I have five Music Man basses? I'm asking my son who plays most of them. I think we have five.
If you're keeping that one.
Yeah, I'm keeping a new one.
All right,
yeah,
it's fine.
So actually, I'm going to show him my new bass.
Do it.
So you're very excited about this.
So you actually buy basses from your own store
Yes. And
then play them. I like that. I think Lee Anderton should take note because he doesn't buy a lot of guitars for himself.
What does he do?
I don't. He has got some guitars, but if I owned a store, I'd have guitars all day long.
Well, technically, I do have guitars all day long.
This is... That's a nice neck material.
Do you know what it is?
It's wood.
It's wood, but it's a completely rosewood neck.
That's awesome.
So, I want to show you the fingerboard. Because the fingerboard is the neck.
Oh, so it's a one piece.
It's a one piece.
That's really, really nice. Very attractive.
And although basses are always heavy, this is very nicely balanced. The one thing when somebody hears about this bass or sees this bass, the reaction is always, I bet it's going to be unbalanced.
Really?
And the fine folks at Music Man have done a fabulous job of making it a very balanced bass. Isn't that beautiful?
That's very nice.
It has way more switches than I need. It has way more knobs than I need.
What's funny is it actually really suits you as well. Oh, I've begun to realize that some instruments suit people better than others do.
Yeah, just drawn to it.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So, again, I don't have to have all these controls. They're kind of nice, but usually this is what I do for the fans out on YouTube. I take my finger, and I go to this knob, and I go all the way up. And then I go to this knob, and I go all the way up.
What about the next one?
I go to this knob, I go all the way up. And with this knob, I go all the way up. And then with this switch, sometimes I flip back and forth between them. We sell Godan basses. We sell Schecter basses.
Let's have a look.
Hi.
Hey, Al.
I do want to show you.
Hey, Al.
Goodbye, then.
Al, don't be shy. Come back.
Cheerio.
Come back.
I'll show you a special bass. Very affordable, very popular. This is Music Man Sterling line of bass.
Oh, yeah, 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 his son.
They're fabulous. And look at this. This is a great bass, plays very, very nice, and that's all it is.
What?
Yes.
That's crazy.
I invite you to play it. Do you play bass?
I really don't, but I could try.
Do you make basses?
I do make a
bass. Yes, you do make basses. Yeah, because we just ordered some basses.
But I'm not the bass. I mean, I'll play it for you, but I mean, I'm no bassist. I mean, you should play. You're a bassist.
I just want you to...
Wait a minute. This was a play for you to completely avoid having to play a bass.
I'm not going
to
do this. The press is here, Rob.
Hello. Nice to meet you. I'm Rob. How you doing?
Corey from the News Leaders.
Oh, awesome.
That's our local
I'm very good.
Jill paper.
Oh, you're from the paper?
I am
the newspaper.
Wow.
Not the old paper. Not the old paper.
She's from the paper.
But the newspaper.
I did a radio thing yesterday and then a clinic. And are you here to talk to me about...
I am if you have a few minutes.
I have a few minutes.
Okay.
Does that call you cheap? Bear with me. And receptive to all good.
Awesome. Perfect.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
coat cabin thing that I just did for a joke, but I realised it's cool. He does a lick. He just got the semitone each time. That sounds really Kirk, doesn't it? Yeah. Plug in, bros.
Is this the guitar you played last night?
Yeah. Now, if anybody's wondering what this is because these two awesome guys, drove 6 and 7 hours respectively to come and see me. Bring the camera
high. You're good,
you're good. Okay, good. And so we opened the store on a Sunday so they can hang out and chill, eat cookies and drink coffee. Thank you.
Thank you.
He's the second person in the States to own a 7-string from Chapman Guitars. It's nice. Show them the back of the headstock. We named this one Bahar, which means sea in Maltese.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's no,
it's
there's
pretty.
No question.
Do her justice. Sail her true.
Every piece of wood is different. So.
It's a pretty one.
I'll be looking for videos.
They'll be there.
Yeah. Yep.
Any last words? Pressure.
I know. I'll do what I can.
Thank you, sir. Say goodbye, YouTube.
Bye-bye, YouTube.
Now, you know, Joe, we didn't manage to finish the tour of the store.
I'd love to.
Because you know what happened?
What?
Customers selling fun. I ate too many cookies. We drank way too much coffee. Although your blood system
that's
is...
That's what happens when you come to Rift City Guitar.
That's what happens when you come to Rift City Guitar Net. So we're going to finish the tour now, and it's a Sunday. We came in to open the store to let a couple of guys in, and we're going to finish the tour of the store. The store tour. In St. Joseph, with Joseph.
Why not?
Now, two of the high-end amplifiers are out of the room because I've been using them. It's the Silverback, best amp in the entire world bar none, and the V10 combo, here. Which is phenomenal.
Please.
It's very, very nice.
These non-noisy...
Yeah, rub it in, bro. So... If you're a bluesy, rocky playing, beautiful country playing, little gigging dude, and you want a beautiful hand-wired British amplifier, this is the real deal. It's a deal, and it's real. Can you say real, Adam?
Real.
I love the way you said real. It's great.
That's how we say it here.
If you want to play absolutely filthy rock, metal, progressive tones, the Silverback is absolutely the best hand-wired, British-made amplifier.
Wait. You were about to move on without showing by far the coolest feature of this amp.
Thank you, sir.
This.
It's magnetically attachable.
Right, because these are what we call magic rocks.
They are. That's what I used to call them when I babysat for some friends. There you go. That's it.
In the right place? Yeah, look at that. Ha! Somebody's going to mess with the knobs. Can't.
Can't
get
in
there. My big fat fingers can't get in there.
It also means that if you're touring and you put it in a bus, knobs don't get knocked off, which is something that happened a lot to me when I toured. Knobs got knocked off.
In a bus?
Yeah, we toured a lot on a bus. So that's that. I advise buying those, especially if you're into metal like Eleanor's. It's getting into the zen feeling, which is what you need when you're entering a high-end boutique room. Do it.
Let's go to the high-end room, please.
Let's do it, man.
So, the first thing you'll notice is we have this, it's a chair, but my wife calls it a, there's some fancy word for it.
A buffet or something?
It was, no.
There's a fancy word for it. It's actually very comfortable. Matt really enjoys it.
The word escapes me. I don't even know it in English or in American.
I wouldn't worry about it.
Yeah, but it's very comfortable.
Let's start this side.
Yes, well, more victory.
There's an Earl.
There's the Earl.
Very, very nice.
50 watt.
It's the first amp I played when I walked into this room.
That is awesome.
You got yourself a Juven.
Got some Marshall.
Absolute.
Yep.
You still got these. These are mostly sold out in England.
Yes.
That's, is this, this is new then, yeah?
Yes. So if somebody sees that
yeah.
and needs it,
You can call us.
Yeah, these are, so yeah, they're sold out in England. They're getting rarer. They made limited numbers. It was an anniversary amp. It's fairly affordable, isn't it?
It's fairly affordable. I don't know the price.
And very good.
But it's fairly affordable.
It's very affordable. Framus.
That is an awesome, awesome guitar. I don't know if you've played that yet, Rob, but it is fantastic.
Wow. Seymour Duncan?
German made.
Mmm.
When we finish the video, you're going to have to play at least 3 notes on it.
Okay. I'm a big fan of the Fenders you got here.
But Rob, stop. You missed something. You forget I'm a bass player.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So the one thing I can
I did just skim over the bass.
The one thing I can intelligently talk about. That happens to be my favorite brand of bass gear.
Okay.
We got them in, maybe about 4 months ago, and they are fantastic. They are so efficient. Just a perfect dynamic range for any bass player. You can really, some bass rigs are set up for a particular kind of music. I've never, ever played a head that had so much versatility that you could literally use it for anything.
Now, Joe does know what he's talking about because we've gigged together now.
We did. It was
We're
fun.
Stage brothers.
It was awesome.
We jumped on with a band, he played bass and he sang, and I played cheesy metal shred.
No, it wasn't cheesy, it was awesome. It was fantastic.
We did our thing.
Imagine Rob Chapman shredding over Creedence.
That's what happened. We didn't get it on camera, though. I'm really sorry.
It was something.
It was just, we did a thing. But
it was
good.
Awesome.
So he knows what he's talking
energy.
About. It was some energy.
Yes.
Mostly from you. So that's a good thing. And these are basses. I know nothing about these, but they're Music Man.
Yes,
we're a very
big supporter of the Music Man. Basses, that's what I like to play. You know, that's the problem with owning a music store. Is you buy all the stuff you like.
Yeah,
it's a mistake you make, but you go into it knowing you're making that mistake.
Well, my favorite guitar in this room is this.
Yeah.
I like that a lot.
That's the Tilly reissue.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful guitar.
Yes, it is. I'm a big fan of Fenders. I mean, obviously, I own my own guitar company, but I don't make Fenders. And I don't make PRSs. I don't make Gibsons. So I like them a lot. These are cute. Little Carla things.
They're called U-basses. That's a solid body U-bass.
Yeah.
This happens to be the California-made. They call them the U.S. U-basses. Uh-huh. They're awesome.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
They're fun
to play, and they sound incredible. You'd think that coming out of a small little instrument like that, it would be...
No. It's a good thing.
Awesome.
You've got Godan,
yes.
Which is fairly popular in America. And the Gretsch. Now, I've played a bunch of these Gretsches. This is my favorite one. Played this in America years ago, actually. Really, really enjoyed it. Have you still got the Penguin?
The Penguin sold while you've been here.
Oh,
so you brought
I
good
sold.
Luck.
I did bring good luck to Penguins. I'd like to think that's a good thing.
Yes.
On the floor, we got a bunch of really cool amps, including this BadCat, which you all know is incredibly great. Most of you will know about the EVH. Less of you will know about the Trainer. I know nothing about this Trainer.
Yes. Classic, classic tube sound.
Hmm.
That's a 40-watt head.
Okay. I like the little handles either side. That's heavy, one side. Damn, that's got weight to it.
Yes.
A lot of glass. It's got a lot of glass. Made in Canada.
Yes. And you can switch,
Canada.
You can actually switch the bias.
Okay, that's cool.
Yes, very cool.
Fixed cathode. Very nice. EVH combo. Bunch of D'Angelicos. Again, I know nothing
very
about...
Very good line for us.
I know nothing about D'Angelicos. Okay. They look pretty, though. Especially this one with the sort of ladder thing. don't know what that does. This one has it, too. It's a ladder.
Yep.
There you go. It's obviously the Stairway to Heaven.
So, we allow that in.
Do you see what I did there?
Yes. You can play that in there, Storm.
And then it's a high-end room, but then you got an MG.
Yeah. That's when we traded in on some other gear. It was so cute, we couldn't resist.
Okay, that's good. A couple of Martins.
Ah, yes.
For Martins. Here's the sweep. You ready? Don't move. Don't move, Joe, because it looked cool.
That's awesome.
That's very good.
I can feel the sweep.
I feel the sweep.
The floor is completely clean now.
Fender Princeton. It's great. So there you go, man. You might notice that this stand is now a little bit more empty because we sold a bunch of Chapmans while we did the thing that I was here to do. In fact, all these behind Joe are sold as well.
Thanks, Rob.
So I think we better get out of here. I'm going to Minneapolis.
We're
going to
go check out Minneapolis.
Yeah. But I'd like to say thank you to every customer that came and saw me. all our new friends, and thanks, please enjoy Riff City Guitar if you can get down here. The Pike case is exceptionally good value. I
could
really like
it. Could
you
please
say guitar?
Guitar. Not guitar.
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 Yeah.
Riff City Guitar.
Guitar.
I've been Rob Chapman.
And I'm Joe.
Take it easy.
Thanks.